Okay, so you start off by pre-casting Haunt. The first dot you want to apply is Agony for a slightly higher chance to get another shard in the first dumping phase. Then apply the rest of your dots. Now you want to pop your Dark Soul followed by Phantom Singularity and Soul Rot. Extend all of your dots with Dark Glare and drain Soul to 3 stacks of Shadow Embrace. Dump all of your shards with Malefic Rapture until Soul Rot and Singularity runs out. Pool shards until Phantom Singularity comes off cooldown again. It's very important that Phantom Singularity is pressed the second it gets available for timing purposes later. Dump shards with the rule of thumb that you should end the Phantom Singularity phase with 2 shards. Now comes the tricky part about Affliction. Your aim will be to get 4 shards off in the next Soul Rot window, meaning you will prepare your dot timers Haunt and Shadow Embrace for when you have 3 shards available. You are able to hold Soul Rot for 10 seconds at this point, for timing purposes that you will see later, so there is no need to rush out the Soul Rot. Phantom Singularity is about to be available again. Once again, it is super important that it is pressed the second it becomes available. You will soon see why all this timing is important. In this Singularity, you can just dump every shard you get. Now you can see that Phantom Singularity and Soul Rot's cooldowns are only 4 seconds apart, despite holding Soul Rot for 6 seconds when it was ready. And they will line up perfectly with having Dark Soul up. This is the timing you have prepared for. When Soul Rot and Singularity are about to be ready, make sure that you prepare all of your dot timers Haunt and Shadow Embrace before going into the dump phase. Your aim here is to get 5 shards off before Soul Rot and Singularity runs out. Now you just wait for Soul Rot and Singularity to line up for Dark Glare, and once you have done that, the cycle is done and you repeat until the boss is dead. Over.